very sincere, you know, answered all the questions. A lot of my questions have been answered, but one of the ones that I would like to ask you is, you know, looking at that bill, seeing how tall it is, and it's, it seems you have done your due diligence in reading that. And my question to you is, if we can't afford this health care bill with the stimulus package and the money we owe China, how are we going to dig this country out of the hole? And how are our children going to dig it out?
That's something that's on my mind. We have just been to the brink of national bankruptcy. I think that, in my opinion, it's the result of mistakes that have been made over the course of years, in some cases decades, some of the worst economic mismanagement the world has ever seen. It didn't start yesterday. It certainly didn't start on January 20th of 2009. So. But there's no question that mistakes have been made and are being made. I think that the way the Federal Reserve is run today is a scandal. I cannot believe that it's within the power of any one human being to take $500 billion of our money and send it to other countries. I can't believe that. So it is true that there are deep, serious problems. I think that most people saw nothing in the way of economic progress for the past 10 years. And in some cases, 30 years. And I think that we need to get back to that point where our natural strengths actually yield results. You know, this is a country of amazingly hardworking people. We work longer hours than anyone else in the world. It used to be the Japanese, now it's us. I don't know if it's something to be proud of or not, but that's a fact. We are incredibly productive people. Our productivity is sky high. You know, believe it or not, our collective efforts as Americans result in $14 trillion worth of income every single year. I know it doesn't end up necessarily in your pocket, sir, or in your pocket, ma'am, but that's $14 trillion produced by 300 million people. I mean, if you do the math, you'll see that every man, woman, and child in this country, and I know it's not the children, but I'm just putting them in there for statistical purposes, are producing almost $50,000 a year in income, every one of us. It goes somewhere, you know. We don't all divide it equally, that's for sure. But the fact is that we are amazingly productive people. We're strong people. We saved the world only 60 years ago. We saved democracy only 60 years ago. We fought communism, we beat it. So, and we're good people too. I mean, over and over again, I find that Americans have a heart. Not just people in this district, but people all over the country. We're good people in our heart. So there's no reason that I can see why you could have all of those advantages and not have a good life for people. I think about this all the time. I don't think that this bill is going to keep us from economic prosperity. On the contrary, I think that our health care bill has been keeping us from economic prosperity until now. I think that for most people, they see that every time they get a raise, it's eaten up by their healthcare premiums. And this happens over and over and over again. So I agree with you that something is seriously out of whack, but I don't think that this bill is anything other than a step in the right direction. I really do.